And welcome to the Bob Carpenter Center in Newark, where tonight the University of Delaware will take on the Hofstra Pride. Good evening, everybody. I'm Matt Janis. I'll be joined by my broadcast partner, Lauren Carrah, coming up in just a little bit. This University of Delaware team looking to build upon the momentum they forged in Boston on Sunday, where they got their first conference win of the year. The Hens entering 6-9 overall on the season, but are up to 1-3 in conference play. Tonight, their opponent, Hofstra, comes in undefeated in the CAA, 4-0 on the year. They are looking for their first ever 5-0 start in conference play. Players to watch here this evening for this Delaware team, it's Erica Brown, the sophomore point guard, coming off a great performance against Northeastern. Really carried the Hens in the second half. She led all scorers with 18 points, and Brown was instrumental in terms of her scoring prowess, but also leadership-wise, which is something this young team has been searching for all season long. Also, Hannah Jardine, her big three gave Delaware the lead for good with just over 2 minutes remaining. For Jardine, a double-figure scoring performance for the ninth time in her last 10 games. Meanwhile, Hofstra is led by Ilo Edeforoka, the sophomore big, averaging nearly a double-double per game this season, and she will certainly be someone that the Hens have to handle in the post. We will turn it over to our public address announcer, Kevin Linton, for now, but Lauren and I will be back with all the play-by-play action in a moment.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, let's meet tonight's starting lineups. First, as we introduce and welcome the visiting Hofstra University Pride. Introducing first at guard, a 5'10 freshman out of Newark, New Jersey, number 2, Ajune Durant. At guard, a 5'10 sophomore of Alexandria, Virginia, number 0, Kelly Loftus. At forward, a 6'3 sophomore of Lowry, Nigeria. Number 10, Ayla Edeforoka. At guard, a 5'5 sophomore of San Juan, Puerto Rico. Number 11, Crystal Luciano. And at guard, a 5'8 junior of Hempstead, New York. Number 12, Darius Polk. Coaching staff for Hofstra University, athletic trainers David Revere. Director of Basketball Operations, Michael Gibson. Assistant coaches are Faisal Khan, Denise King, Adia Ravel. And ladies and gentlemen, in her ninth season at Hofstra University, the head coach, Krista Kilburn-Stubeski.
Oh, Throw is good. Getting it inside to Durant. Durant's shot wouldn't go. Her follow is short off the front rim. Rebound loose on the floor. Tipped by Brown, but chased down by Hofstra. And a Pride will go to work. Back pass outside to Luciano. Luciano dribbling near the midcourt stripe. Left wing feed over to Loftus. Back up top to Durant. Durant, right wing give to Falk. Falk hands it off to Luciano. Calls out a play. Left wing feed to Loftus. Back to Luciano. Right wing chest pass over to Falk. Drives in the lane. Draws the defense out to Loftus. Left wing triple wouldn't go. And then a foul on the rebound called against Hannah Jardine. Jardine was trying to box out, but looked like she undercut Luciano. And it's called for the foul, her first, and the team's first as well, a minute 40 into the game.
And Hofstra is a very physical CAA team, one of the most physical CAA teams Delaware is going to see this in conference play. So it's going to be interesting to see how Delaware can match the physicality tonight.
Inbound to Durant. Her quick jumper just right of the lane would not go. It rattled out. Rebound grabbed by Delaware. Here comes Erica Brown the other direction for UD. Bounce pass top of the key to Green. Green dribbling towards the left wing. Now turns the corner. Try to drive baseline. Is cut off. Tries an entry feed for Caracho. Had that poked aside, but it goes out of bounds. Last touch by the Pride. And as a result, it'll stay with Delaware. 13 to shoot. 18 minutes left of the first half, tied at 3. Hens got to be a bit more secure with their passes here in the early going. A couple have been knocked away. Brown triggering the inbound, baseline right, looking and getting it to Jardine, far corner. Jardine being bumped the whole way, but they'll call a walk. Looked like she was being nudged towards the sideline. They'll call an offensive foul on Hannah Jardine. Wow, tough call on Jardine. That's her second, team second. So Hannah has to go out just over 2 minutes into this game. Did you see an offensive foul?
I didn't, and it really looked like she had walked. Didn't really look like there was contact there.
Yeah, I thought if anything, the contact came from the Hofstra defender. You either are going to call a foul on the Pride or a travel against Jardine. They call an offensive foul. Now backdoor cut. Etta Faroka on the right block. Can't finish in tight, but gets her own rebound, ripping it away from Nicholas and misses point blank in the middle of the lane. This time Nicholas does pull down the rebound and Delaware the other way. Brown dribbling forecourt, high screen from Caracciolo, crossover move on the right elbow, gets it inside to Joy. Joy spins, seals the defender, can't hit the left-hand shot. Rebound loose on the floor, Nicholas after it is tied up by Hofstra. Arrow will keep it with Delaware. Good hustle from both teams that time. It was Nicholas hitting the floor, and Afaroka was down there as well. Also in the area was Darius Falk. So the inbound will come baseline left here from UD. It'll be Brown to get it in. Brown looking for some help, lobs it out near center court, it's taken away. Loftus jumped the passing lane, got the steal, weaves her way into the lane the other direction, got her shot blocked from behind by Nicholas. Taylor out of there with the ball, 3-on-2 the other way if she hurries. Taylor on the left wing will slow things up and find her point guard. Good decision there from the freshman who struggled with that situation last week. Now Brown off the dribble, quick shot would not go, and a rebound grabbed by Ed Efferoka, but you like to see that maturity from Taylor. Here's Hofstra the other way. Quick three in transition. Good. Loftus left wing triple, and it's 6-3 Pride. Delaware trapped in the backcourt. Brown with two bodies around her. Good job to spin out of it. Green gets away with an obvious walk. Lobs it forward to Nicholas, and that pass knocked out of bounds by Luciano. It'll stay with Delaware. Jody Sawyer going to come in. Courtney Green out. That was very awkward looking from Green.
And this press that we're seeing from Hofstra is a little different from the one we saw up at Northeastern. Northeastern was really just a playback. They were forcing Delaware to take time off the shot clock. Here, Hofstra is attacking the Delaware players and forcing them to make these decisions.
Here's Brown making a good decision, turning the quarter off the bounce, driving into the body of Ashade Durant. And Durant going to be called for the blocking foul. Falk was in the area as well. See which one gets it. It's going to actually be Falk. Her first, team second, 16-33 left first half. Delaware down 6-3. Sawyer gets it in, right wing to Nicholas. Nicholas will hand it off to Brown. Brown looks back at her head coach, Tina Martin, calls out a play. Erica dribbling between the rings, center of the floor. Now, right hand bounce towards the wing, hands it off to Sire. Top of the circle to Nicholas. Left hand bounce towards the wing, hands it off that side of the floor to Taylor. Spinning her way into the basket, shot rejected out of bounds. Angie White, the Delaware native, just checking in. And the Sanford grad made her presence felt immediately.
And that lane right now is very, very tight for Delaware. The Hofstra players are sagging off of them. Someone needs to hit an outside shot similar to Northeastern to open up that lane.
Well, we saw Brown do it, which really helped the offense. Here's an inbound to Caracciolo. Go to work with a left hand. Powers one up and banks it home. And Delaware is back to within one. Just under 4 minutes into this game, Joy Caracciolo continuing to have success in the post. Hens having to play without Hannah Jardine, who has two fouls early. Chastity Taylor tips away, a backdoor feed for White. And it'll go out of bounds, remaining with Hofstra when we return. Timeout on the floor, 15:56 to go in the opening half. It's 6-5. Delaware trailing by a point. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV.
Hey fans, 12 and younger, do you want to be a future Blue Hen? Join the Future Hens Club presented by St. Francis Healthcare for invites to exclusive events and free admission to select UD games.
Meet coaches and players like us.
Get your official Future Hens t-shirt and more surprises.
To join, log on bluehens.com with a parent, click on Fan Zone, then Kids Club. Click Register Here, fill out your information, and click Submit.
Join today!
My roots are 3,000 miles away, but now they are here in Newark. I won't let you down. You're my home crowd now. Experience it.
2 minutes into this game, here's why that's important, Laura. She's one of the better scorers for this Delaware team. Double figures, 9 of the last 10 games, and also one of the better outside shooters, which is something the Hens desperately need.
Yeah, they desperately need both her and Courtney Green, which both are on the bench right now, as we talked about earlier, opening up that lane for Joy Caracciolo and for Makeda Nicholas to work inside.
Inbound for Hofstra here, goes top of the circle to Luciano. Luciano doing some work, going under a screen. Sawyer frees her up for a three. That misses badly, but another offensive rebound pulled down by Durant. Her shot blocked from behind by Caracciolo. And Sawyer out of there with a basketball. Feeds it forward to Brown. Brown left the lane spinning, and a clear offensive foul against Erica Brown as she pushed off on her way towards the paint. That'll give it back to the Pride. Brown's first and the team's third.
And we saw Erica Brown on Sunday against Northeastern take that short pull-up shot, especially in the first half, to keep Delaware within striking distance. That would have been the perfect opportunity for her there to pull up with that jump shot.
So now Pride basketball up by one. Delaware in their matchup zone, getting a little aggressive here on the perimeter. Jumping out on a passing lane. Couldn't get the steal, though. Out top, it's Luciano. Left wing feed to Loftus. Loftus tried to drive the lane, was turned aside. Kicks it outside around the perimeter to Falk, and Falk walked before she put it on the deck. Trying to drive through the slashing opening on that left side gap. But a little too quick for her own good, and that'll give it back to UD. Sire gets it into Taylor in the backcourt. Cross-court bounce pass to Brown. Back pass to Taylor, forward to Sire. Good break from Delaware. Now Sire drops it without any pressure, but able to get it back and will set up the offense. 16 on the timer. She dribbles foul line right. Looking inside for Nicholas. Good bounce pass to get it to her. Nicholas turn and face. One dribble up with a shot. Rattles around and out. Hit every part of the rim but wouldn't fall. Rebound Hofstra. It was pulled down by White. White outletting it forward to a hustling Falk. Falk stopped by the Delaware defense, and Hofstra will set things up. Cross-court feed, far corner to Luciano. Luciano trying to drive baseline. Good rotation from Taylor. Forced a turnover as Brown ends up with the ball. Trying to beat the Hofstra defense back. Goes all the way to the 10 and floats it home with a left hand. And Delaware has its first lead of the night. Nice take from Erica Brown in transition that time. 7-6, ends back up by a point. 14-10 left in this first half. Hofstra with the ball, dribbling from right to left. Feeding it far corner to Loftus. Loftus up top to Falk. Falk, good awkward angle pass inside to Durant. Durant, cross-court feed back out to Falk, left wing. Finding a wide open White at the foul line. Her jumper would not go. Offensive rebound corralled by Falk, but had it stripped away by Brown. Brown brings it forward for Delaware across the timeline. Slowing up top of the key. Hands it off to Sawyer, and Sawyer will trigger the offense. 13:40 left first half. Delaware 7, Hofstra 6. Hens with the ball. Brown, left wing bounce. Played off of by Falk. Feeds left elbow to Caracciolo. Head fake. Now the right hand dribble. Near corner feed to Sawyer. Driving baseline bump. No call. And they'll say she stepped on the baseline. A lot of contact there to not get a call. It goes back to Hofstra. A couple of subs. Returning for Delaware, Courtney Green, and for the first time, Steph Leon. Story there, evidently the proper pronunciation of Steph's last name is Leon, not Leon. Took us 4 years to find out. We apologize to the Leon family.
But we just saw both Joy Caracciolo and Erica Brown take a seat right there on that sub. Both gave great minutes right there, especially Joy Caracciolo. The coaches were worried about how long she was going to stay in the game. She did a great job, 7 great minutes out of her.
She did indeed, and now the inside presence of Leon forces a tough shot. Rebound grabbed by Green as misfiring in tight was White. Here comes Delaware up a point. Green on a hesitation move, driving towards the foul line. Left elbow feed to Nicholas. Nicholas attacking off the bounce, fouled one her way to the basket. Tried a lefty finish and got hacked by Angie White. And that'll be White's first, team's third. And two free throws coming here for Makeda Nicholas.
In the last couple games, we've seen Makeda Nicholas turn around and take that jump shot right there from the elbow. That time she saw Angie White up in her face, she put the ball on the floor and got to the basket.
First free throw is up and through for Nicholas, 54% foul shooter on the year. Makeda averaging 3.5 points, 5 rebounds per contest, and the second one gets the shooter's roll. So Delaware now its largest lead of the night at 9-6. They have scored 6 consecutive points over almost 4 full minutes. Hofstra with the ball the other direction, dribbling out near center court, Loftus. Right wing feed goes to Falk. Falk drives to the lane, kicks it near corner to Loftus. Up top to Asia Jackson, who's in for the first time. Right wing feed over to Falk. Falk splits the defense and gets into the lane and floats one in with a finger roll, high arcing finger roll, and it's 9-8. Lead down to 1 for UD, more pressure from Hofstra. Green, cross-court feed to get it across the timeline to Sire. Nice dish that time from Courtney Green. Sire dribbling foul line right. Looking inside, Nicholas was there. Got it to her a little late. That allowed the defense White to recover, but a nice up-and-under move from Nicholas. Got the defender in the air, but a better recovery from White. Her second block shot of the game sends it to the baseline. It'll stay Delaware ball 10 to shoot. White averaging 3 blocks per contest already this season.
And give credit to Makeda Nicholas right now for going at Angie White. She's showing no fear in there and attacking the basket.
Ooh, Sawyer tried to take a timeout, but the 5 count comes first. Turnover Delaware there. The Hens were a little late breaking. And as a result, they give it back to the Pride. Chastity Taylor will take a seat. Erica Brown back into the game for Delaware. 5-on-the-4 for the Hens. Brown and Green on the top of the zone. Back line near side Sawyer. Center Leon. And a far side, Makeda Nicholas. 12 minutes remaining in this opening half. Delaware's lead is 1. Loftus near wing, lobs it top of the circle to White. White around the perimeter, right wing to Jackson, trying to get it inside to Loftus, tipped aside by Leon. Loose on the floor, far sideline, tipped out of bounds off of a hustling Brown. It'll stay with Hofstra, but Tina Martin applauding the effort from her basketball team. It takes us to a timeout on the floor, 11:48 left to go in the first half. Delaware leading Hofstra by a score of 9-8. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WTOB.
Hello, Delaware fans. This is Coach Brock at beautiful Lums Pond State Park, just minutes from Delaware Stadium. I'm inviting you to come to the park, enjoy their year-round camping, boat rentals, equestrian center, and so much more. While you're here, experience the Go Ape Treetop Adventure. Go Ape is an outdoor experience where you can live life adventurously and experience the park from 50 feet up in the trees, hanging by a wire. To learn more about Go Ape or to book your visit to the course, visit www.goape.com. Go Hens!
Hold on to me as we go. Just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Oh, 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 oh.
Center in Newark, 11:48 remaining in this first half. Delaware on top of Hofstra by a score of 9-8. This Blue Hen broadcast being presented by Brandywine Electronics. Visit BEL.com for more info. Brandywine Electronics, you need audio help. Joe Dombrowski and his staff are the place to turn. Hofstra ball in the forecourt, throwing it in far sideline. 9 on the timer as they get it into Jackson. Jackson dribbling towards the top of the key. Right wing feed over to Falk. Falk puts it on the deck, in some trouble, 1 to shoot. Extra pass, late shot, violation. Giving it back to Delaware. They tried 1 too many feeds. By the time Asia Jackson got it, shot clock had expired. Good half-court defense from UD. Crystal Luciano will come in as a result. Falk subs out. Dueling point guards who can both play at the same time. Very similar to what Delaware has, just a little bit more experience. Here, one of those turnovers gives it away for the Hens as the point guard Brown throws it to Hofstra. The steal from Asia Jackson, who takes it straight to the basket and is fouled. She'll head to the line to shoot a pair.
And this Hofstra press that we're seeing right now, Hofstra's a very athletic, very quick team. Delaware needs to be smart with the basketball. Use that reversal pass that they have in the backcourt and use that middle pass. There's multiple ways they could break this. It just can't be back and forth between the two point guards.
First foul on Sawyer. Fourth foul on the Hens. First free throw no good for Jackson, who's only a 62% shooter on the season. So get one more line left. Chance to tie this game. 8.5 minutes in. Second free throw, a switch, so we're tied at 9. Hens with some foul trouble early. Hannah Jardine on the bench. 2 fouls, 2 minutes in. Try to play their way through it. Sawyer, right side feed to Green. Green over the top of the timeline with a lob pass to Brown, and Brown will trigger the offense. Calls for Sawyer to come get it. Hands it off to her between the rings. Jody dribbles right wing, now feeds it top of the key to Brown. Brown left hand bounce, left of the lane, stepping back towards the wing. Up top to Nicholas, 6 on the timer. Nicholas driving to the foul line. Baseline left feed to Leon, her jumper, Liana, beg your pardon, no good. Rebound pulled down by Jackson. Jackson will dribble it forward, feeds Luciano trailing the play. Lob pass inside for Etta Faroka, tipped aside by Leon. Goes out of bounds, it'll stay with Hofstra. 10:49 left of the first half. And a roll of the dice here for Delaware. Tina Martin gonna bring Hannah Jardine back in with 2 fouls as Leon goes out. Also out of the contest, Makeda Nicholas. She is replaced by Joy Caracciola. Etta Faroka has some blood on her top lip. Nobody attending to her. Now the trainer is slowly but surely heading over. Krista Kilburn-Stavesky, ninth season as the head coach at Hofstra, asking the official, where'd that blood come from? Meanwhile, nobody for Hofstra making an effort to clean it up, so Delaware trainer Kelly Stafford goes over to take care of it. Boy, Stavesky was a little upset. I think the official telling her it was incidental contact. Still more blood on the floor. Evidently Delaware's responsibility, so Stafford has to come back out to clean it up again. That sends the teams over to the benches. All things considered, not a bad start. Just over 9 minutes in here. Delaware tied. This is a Hofstra team that's been playing as well as any in the conference this season.
Absolutely. Starting the conference off at 4-0, one of the best starts that Hofstra's ever had in CAA play. The Hens right now are hanging right with them, and they're making the smart plays right now offensively. They're not forcing things like we saw in the first half of that Northeastern game. They're playing within their game and not playing at the pace of Hofstra.
Great point, and it's worked out well so far for Delaware. So here out of this impromptu timeout, Hofstra will throw it in baseline left. Triggering the inbound will be Luciano. Pride looking for their first ever 5-0 start within the league in program history. Far corner feed to Loftus. She'll feed it up top to Luciano, who triggers the offense. 15 left on the timer. Tied at 9. 10:40 to go in this opening half. Right wing chest pass over to Loftus. Loftus feeding it far corner. White. White, the Delaware product, feeds it to Durant, who walked. Freshman. Little too quick for her own good. Try to spin move, drag the back pivot, and that'll give it back to the Hens. Brown dribbling it far sideline. Back feed to Green. Green to Brown across the timeline. Erica Brown bounce pass near the circle, near backcourt. Good catch by Green. She balances the line. Delaware in some trouble, splits a double team, and the Hens will have to take a timeout. That's their use it or lose it timeout. Still more than half of this opening half to go. But that was an ugly-looking start to the possession for UD. I think a good timeout from Tina Martin.
Almost the same exact play we saw earlier when Erica Brown passed it back into the middle of the floor to Jody Salyer, and a defender was standing right there. The trap went to get Erica Brown. We saw the same play right here just now. Delaware needs to send someone to the free throw line. Hannah Jardine standing down the corner. The Delaware players need to come to the basketball when they see Courtney Green pick up the ball like that. They can't stand and watch her. These Hofstra guards are too athletic and too quick. She needs help there.
With two-time All-CAA guard Lauren Carah, Matt Janis, courtside here at the Carpenter Center from the Value Days broadcast table presented by Exxon and Shell. We are tied at 9 out of Delaware's called timeout. 10.25 minutes remaining in this first half. Brown with it near wing for UD. Feeds in the corner to Green. Her baseline jumper, air ball by about 2 feet, but it goes out of bounds off the Pride. Inexplicably, Luciano tried to catch it. She fumbled it, and it goes out of bounds back to UD, which is good news. The bad news is something is off right now with Courtney Green's shot. You don't see her miss it like that ever, and it was deep by a wide margin.
And the shot clock was going down there. Not the best shot Courtney Green could have taken, but two hands were in her face. A very difficult shot she would have been able to make anyway. But with the shot clock going down, she was trying to make a play there.
Yeah, had about four left on the timer, so you at least understand why she pulls the trigger on the shot. They say no possession for Hofstra, so now two on the shot clock as the Hens will throw it in baseline right. They had originally reset it. Brown will trigger, looking backdoor for Caracciolo, can't get it to her, gets it into Jardine. She's stripped, ball is loose, shot clock violation, gives it back to the Pride. So not the prettiest of starts here, but that's Delaware's style of game. Let's be honest, the Hens seem to thrive at this muck and grind style that we've seen from them so far this season. It's how they won and come from behind fashion against Northeastern on Sunday.
And it's something we've talked about all season. They play in segments right now, and this not being one of their best segments, so Delaware just needs to hang tough right now.
Courtney Green called for a foul. Crowd didn't like it. On a cross-court dish, Green tried to cut the passing lane. Looked like maybe she bumped Kelly Loftus. It's Green's first, team's fifth. Hens have five team fouls, Hofstra with three. 9:53 left in this first half. Still a 9-9 tie. Inbound goes top of the circle. Luciano dishes it off to a teammate. Loftus deep three wouldn't go. Nobody got the ball. Loftus chased it down. Hens out hustled to that one. And Luciano ends up with the top of the key. Left box feed to a wide open Durant who lays it home. And Tina Martin won't be happy about that exchange. Hens getting beat. Caught flat foot. Not going after the ball. Brown lob feed forward from Green. Back to Green, top of the circle. Right baseline pass to Sire, hits the jumper, and we're retied at 11.
And Delaware right there cutting it very close again. We almost saw two turnovers in that possession, but they were finally able to get it down the floor to where they had a two-on-one possession.
And nice job on the secondary break. Ended up working out pretty well for UD. Another skip pass from Hofstra, and open jumper good from Loftus as a result. Fine feed, Luciano, right wing to near corner, and Loftus swishes the triple. 14-13, Pride lead is one. Excuse me, 14-11, Pride lead is three. Brown with the basketball in the backcourt. Good feed forward to Green. Crosses the timeline with 1 second to spare. And they get it back to Brown out near center court. Brown dribbling in front of the Hofstra bench, 30 feet from the basket. Now towards the top of the key. Dribbling right elbow, right wing feed to Sire. Near corner to Green. Green driving into the lane. Right hand layup is good. Nice take from Courtney Green, and it's a one-point game again.
What a take by Courtney Green to attack that seam right there. The help defense for Hofstra didn't slide over. She took the ball straight to the basket.
8 1/4 minutes remaining in this first half. 14-13, Hofstra by one. Left wing dribbles Loftus. Loftus gives it up to Jackel King-Gilchrist, who just checked in. And she's deep with a near corner three. Rebound pulled down by Delaware. Here come the Hens. Brown left wing towards the foul line. Bumped on her way to the lane, and the foul called against Hofstra. Nickel Dimer called on the Pride. That's the fourth team foul against Hofstra. 8-1 remaining in this first half. As the foul called on King-Gilchrist, her first. King-Gilchrist will take a seat. She's replaced by Darius Falk. Sire to the bench for UD. Chastity Taylor back into the game for the Hens. Brown will trigger the inbound baseline right. Green comes wide open. Backdoor cut. Got hammered on the way up. No call. Delaware not getting many whistles early. Rebound Hofstra. Nice job by Loftus as nobody stops. Ball goes straight to the rim but misses the lefty layup. Jardine in traffic pulls down the rebound. Outlets it forward to Brown, looking to run. Feeds near corner, wide open. Green for three, rattled it out. Offensive board, Caracciolo fouled on the putback, and she'll head to the line to shoot a pair when we return. Timeout on the floor, 7:40 left to go in the opening half. It's Hofstra 14, Delaware 13. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV. We are the champions.
Throw your hands up, welcome to the other land of dreamers, brothers, sisters, others. Yeah, we all fight like that.
You can now watch all Hens All Access content on any of your devices. Whether you're at the store on your phone or on the couch with your iPad or laptop, Hens All Access live and on-demand content is just a touch away. Not only will live games be available on your mobile devices, they'll also be available in high definition. Best of all, you don't even need an app. Just click over to BlueHens.com on your device and take the Hens anywhere you go.
Center in Newark, 7:40 left to go in the first half. Hofstra 14, Delaware 13. Kelly Loftus, one of the important players on this Pride lineup. Out of the game right now for the Pride, sitting on the end of the bench in extreme discomfort, holding her chest area. Not sure whether she took a shot there or what happened, but right above almost the breastplate is kind of where she's holding at the moment. She's going to go back to the locker room, so we'll keep an eye on that. Loftus in some severe discomfort. Either while 14-13, Pride lead is one, but Delaware chance to go back in front. Two free throws coming here for Joy Caracciolo. Caracciolo standing line right for the Hens. First free throw for the BC transfer, who's been better at the line here of late, hits it. She's knocked down 9 of her last 11 free throws now, Lauren, a career 50% foul shooter. Now on the season, has her mark up to 58%. Second shot line right, line drive put through, and Delaware's up a point, 15-14. So here comes the Pride, walking it across the midcourt stripe, Luciano. Right wing feed over to Jackson. Jackson gets it in on the right block, D. Thomas Palmer in for the first time. She hands it off to Durant, back out to D. Thomas Palmer far quarter. She puts a head fake on Caracciolo, got her in the air, then put the shot up, got it to go, and the foul. Nice show of the ball there from D. Thomas Palmer, who's not blessed with a ton of athleticism, but knows how to play the game. And her moves kind of move in slow motion, but they're effective.
And she came in firing nonetheless, just stepped on the floor, and she was able to put on a move like that on Joy Caracciolo, and now she's at the free throw line for a three-point play.
Foul shot up, high arcer, right rim no good, rebound Green. So the lead stays at one for Hofstra, 16-15, 7 1/4 minutes remaining in the opening half. Brown angling it across the midcourt stripe towards the right wing, up top to Green. Green left-hand bounce towards the wing, now flaring into the corner. Feeds it out near center court to Jardine, who's playing with two fouls. Chest pass right wing to Brown, 10 on the timer. Brown up top, Caracciolo, left-hand bounce, left of the lane. Floats one up, too strong off the glass, rebound grabbed by the Pride. Pulled down by Durant, long outlet pass forward to Luciano, into the lane, floats it home, a left hand. Nice, tough angle finish from Luciano, and it's a three-point Hofstra edge.
And Luciano, a very difficult player to contain. She's very quick, very shifty, and there, Delaware played her as tight as they could. She just got off a very good shot.
Here's Green, top of the key, lobs it, left elbow, Jardine, head fake, couldn't get the defender in the air. Kicks it back out to Green, 12 on the timer. Green, chest pass left wing to Brown. Brown, right hand bounce towards the lane. Left wing over to Jardine. Jardine spinning in the far corner, 3 on the timer. Out top to Brown, lost her bounce. It's picked up by Hofstra. Steal for the Pride, they blow it dead, not sure why. Shot clock violation, either way, it's Hofstra ball. 6:18 left first half, Pride up by 3. Out of the game goes Asia Jackson. In for the first time, Aliona Leon. Meanwhile, out for Delaware, Caracciolo. She's replaced by Leon. Boy, wouldn't you know it, right after we get word that Leon's pronunciation of her name is changed. There's a 3 here, left wing from Luciano, would not go. Offensive board, D. Thomas Palmer. Her shot rejected by Leon and pulled down by the senior, who will outlet it for Desire, who weaves left, now right, and slows things up. But on the same day, we find out it's Leon, not Leon. Delaware faces a girl named Leon. What are the odds of that? Not good for a broadcaster who's trying to change his ways. Brown driving towards the lane, kicks it out to Taylor. Taylor, top of the key to Brown for 3, it's good. Straight away triple, and we're tied at 18. 5:34 left first half. Hofstra the other direction. Jackson near wing had it knocked away by Sawyer, but chased it down. Feeds it around the perimeter, far wing to Leon. Leon driving baseline, near corner to Jackson. Her 3 short, rebound hustled down by Jardine. And Delaware goes the other way. Outlets it forward to Brown. Brown looking to push, 2-on-2, stop and pop, elbow, jumper good. Left elbow shot through for Brown. The Hens go on a 5-0 run. They lead by two. Timeout Hofstra as Krista Kilburn-Stavesky laying into her team as they go over to the bench. Nice spurt here from UD.
And especially this spurt, all because of Erica Brown. We're seeing her get into the flow of the game now. A kick-out pass from Stephanie Leone, wide open, was able to knock that down. In transition just now, instead of attacking the basket and getting that charge call we've seen her get many times this season, pulling up and hitting that jump shot, she shoots so well.
Delaware women's basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV, being brought to you by the Glasgow Medical Aid Units with locations in Glasgow, Newark, and Middletown. Save time, save money, get well. Glasgow Medical Aid Units. 5:11 to go in this first half. Delaware's lead is two. Hofstra with the ball out of their called timeout. Hens with Brown, Jardine, Sawyer, Leon, and Taylor in the game. Luciano running point for the Pride, has it out near center court. Dribbling it aimlessly top of the key, right elbow feed inside to Etta Faroka, who walked on a spin move, trying to drop step left of the lane. Turnover gives it back to UD, and the Hens all of a sudden digging in defensively. I thought early it was poor offense from Hofstra. Lately, it's been good half-court defense from UD.
Very good, and Delaware is collapsing very quickly on that paint, and we're seeing the Delaware guards hustling out to these shooters, forcing Hofstra to take bad shots right now.
Here come the Hens. Brown with it, left wing. Crossover move towards the lane. Now spins back out to the perimeter. 4:42 left first half. Delaware 20, Hofstra 18. Sawyer with it right wing. Left hand bounce towards the top. Now skirts her way into the lane. Feeds near corner back out to Taylor. Taylor drives to the foul line over to Leon. Push shot, right elbow would not go. Hofstra the rebound. Out letting it forward and Loftus. Loftus on the left wing. Firing a three in transition. Back rim no. Rebound Brown. Chance to run. 3-on-2 if she hurries. Weaves left, now right. Feeds it off to Taylor. Bumped on her way up. Couldn't get the roll, but it'll head to the stripe to shoot a pair. Good strength there from Chastity Taylor as she collided on the way up with a hustling Luciano. Almost snuck it over the rim, but Taylor to the line to shoot two, where she struggled this year. She's 1 of 11 at the stripe on the season.
And a great job by Erica Brown to make that defense collapse on her. It was a 2-on-2 situation. She attacked the basket, forced both defenders to attack, and was able to dish it off to Chastity Taylor.
First free throw, though, rattles out for Chastity Taylor. She'll get one more here. Back into the game comes Darius Falk. Falk replacing Crystal Luciano. So Taylor, 1 of 12 now at the stripe of the season. Leon into the lane early. Front rim, the free throw. Whistle comes. They'll say Etta Faroka went in first. That's a gift for Delaware if they call it that way. Leon was there first, and now they overrule it. It was Steph Leon who got in the lane, the violation giving it back to Hofstra. Been an odd game so far, Lauren. It doesn't seem like either team can get into a rhythm, but it's because of each defense, which I think if you're Delaware, you'll take. Hofstra likes to run. They play higher scoring games. Top of the circle, dribble Loftus. Loftus feeding left wing to Falk. Falk around the perimeter. Now gets it inside to Etta Faroka. Her shot blocked by Leon. Ends up in the hands of Jardine. Outlets it forward to Brown, looking to run. Hofstra back defensively. Good decision from the sophomore to slow things up. Should reverse the ball, had Sire with space. Instead, Erica wants to drive. Now stops just inside the foul line and hits the jumper. Reverse the ball, what? Erica Brown feeling it and hits it from 14 feet.
And she is getting Hofstra on that high ball screen right now with the hesitation dribble. Hofstra's caught off guard. She's either pulling up and hitting the jump shot or attacking the basket.
Delaware's largest lead of the game at 22-18. Here's the Pride the other way. Leon right wing, feeding it left wing to Falk. Falk inside, Etta Faroka working on Leon. Her shot altered by Leon and ends up in the hands of Jardine. Outletting it forward to Sawyer. No numbers, so Jody slows things up. Good decisions for the point guard so far today for Delaware. Leon on a handoff, left elbow, gives it back to Brown. Step back, jumper left of the lane is good. Erica Brown heating up, and Delaware's largest lead of the game. They're up six. 24-18, just under 3 minutes left in this opening half. Hens all of a sudden starting to close out half strong. That was a problem early in the season. Now a turnover Hofstra. poor pass. Loftus trying to get it inside to Falk. Gives it back to UD when we return. Standing ovation for the Bob Carpenter Center faithful. 2:47 left to the first half. It's the Hens 24, Hofstra 18. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
Rush hour or relax hour? It's your choice. Dark. Moving forward.
My roots are 3,000 miles away, but now they are here in Newark. I won't let you down. You're my home crowd now. Experience it.
Welcome back to the Carpenter Center. 2:47 remaining in the first half. Delaware, its largest lead of the game, 24-18. The Hens doing a nice job here. A 9-0 run from UD. Their ball out of the immediate timeout. Sawyer walking it across the timeline for UD. High post feed to Leon. Feeds it outside top of the circle to Brown. Brown directing traffic, calling for a high screen. Erica uses it, kicks it right wing to Taylor. Taylor at the foul line to Leon. Back right wing to Brown. Brown looking inside for Jardine. Lobs it to her on the right block. Good seal move. Couldn't finish with the right hand. And the rebound grabbed by Hofstra. Good board pulled down in traffic from the Delaware native White. White outlets it forward to Durant. Looking to run. Lobs it to White running the floor. And she lays it home with the right hand. Ending a 9-0 run and bringing Hofstra back to within four. 2:07 and ticking left in this first half, Lauren. Pretty good job there by Hofstra in transition. They've not done much of that tonight.
A very good job by Hofstra. That's one of Delaware's weaknesses. We've seen them do a good job so far tonight. Just a little lapse right there in the transition defense.
And one of the Pride's strengths. They love to get out in transition. Sawyer with 9 on the timer, dribbling aimlessly top of the key. Good entry feed, though. Right block to Jardine. Lefty scoop wouldn't go. Follow from Taylor. Too strong off the glass. And this time the rebound corralled by Hofstra. Pulled down it. This time by Luciano. Luciano outlets it forward to White. White up and under move. Air ball the jumper in the lane. Taylor ends up with the ball. Weaves her way to the midcourt stripe. Stops and finds the point guard Sawyer, who brings it across and feeds it forward to Brown. Brown again off a high screen. Stop and pop. Jumper's good. High Archer hits nothing but net just left of the elbow. And it's back to a 6-point Delaware lead.
And Hofstra continues to play Erica Brown underneath that screen. It's almost as if Hofstra right now is going fourth man on Erica Brown. Eventually, they're going to have to step up and play her.
Cross court feed, near corner to Loftus. Loftus had it stolen away. Sawyer tipped it to Brown. And Brown fouled on her way towards the basket. That is the 17th foul against the Pride. And as a result, Erica Brown going to shoot a 1-1. Delaware doing a good job choosing their spots when to run. They've made, it seems like so far tonight, every right decision. As Brown electing to sprint forward and got bumped by Kelly Loftus. Loftus first, team seventh. Brown at the line for the front end. As she puts it through, she'll get one more 7-point Delaware edge.
And Delaware continues to stay within their game right now, not playing to the up and down pace that Hofstra likes to play to.
Second free throw, line right for Brown. It's front rim no good. Leon tipped the rebound. It's loose on the floor. It's ripped away from her by Jackson. Jackson lost it out of bounds, but saved it just before it crossed the baseline. So Hofstra does end up with possession. Good hustle from Asia Jackson. Here comes Luciano Ford. Feeds a trailing Jackson. Top of the circle to King Gilchrist. King Gilchrist driving to the lane. Left wing feed to Luciano. Three goes in and out. Back in again. Boy, that hit every part of the tin before falling through. And Hofstra's back to within four.
And there was no one, no Delaware player even near her there. She had time to catch and reset herself. There was that much space between her and the Delaware defender. They can't allow Hofstra these three-point shots, or it's going to get them right back in the game.
Brown, left wing, up top Leon. Right wing to Sires. Skip, jump, and a walk. That'll give it back. to Hofstra. A little pushing and shoving there. Exchange between Sawyer and White. Hens actually fortunate there. I think Jody initiated a lot of that contact on her way back up the floor. No call. They play on. Two rivals battling. Hofstra down four. 12 seconds left in the half as the Pride bring it forward. Luciano near wing feed to Durant. Durant gives it up top to Luciano. Four left. Luciano into the lane. Scoops it up. Rattles out. Rebound Caracciolo. That'll take us to the half. Great first 20 minutes from UD. They take a four-point lead to intermission. Pretty good job there from Tina Martin's crew. Wasn't always the prettiest of first halves, but they closed strong. A nice execution there. They found something with Erica Brown late.
Absolutely, and it's all Delaware's defense right now that's keeping them in the game. And then Erica Brown exploding in that first half, reading Hofstra's defense very well. When they're going to go third man and you have the ability to shoot the basketball, absolutely shoot that pull-up jump shot. And Erica Brown really coming into her own with her shot right now.
So at the break, it is Delaware 27, Hofstra 23. We will go to commercial when we come back. Phil Lehman back in our Newcastle Studios. He'll have the halftime report. Hens by four at the half.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
My roots are 3,000 miles away, but now they are here in Newark. I won't let you down. You're my home crowd now. Experience it.
Hold on to me as we go. Just know you're not alone. 'Cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
It really is a Blue Hen state of mind, and it's all about heading back to Baltimore to defend our crown. It's called March Madness for a reason. Your Blue Hen squad returns to Royal Farms Arena for the CAA Men's Basketball Championship, March 6th through March 9th. So much to see, so much to do. For the absolute best seats available to Blue Hen fans, visit BlueHens.com for more information.
We are the champions. Welcome to the other land of dreamers, brothers, sisters, others. Yeah, we all fight like that.
Hey fans, 12 and younger, do you want to be a future Blue Hen? Join the Future Hens Club presented by St. Francis Healthcare for invites to exclusive events and free admission to select UD games.
Meet coaches and players like us.
Get your official Future Hens t-shirt and more surprises.
To join, log on bluehens.com with a parent, click on Fan Zone, then Kids Club. Click Register Here, fill out your information, and click Submit.
Join today!
Rush hour or relax hour? It's your choice. Dark. Moving forward.
You can now watch all Hens All Access content on any of your devices. Whether you're at the store on your phone or on the couch with your iPad or laptop, Hens All Access live and on-demand content is just a touch away. Not only will live games be available on your mobile devices, they'll also be available in high definition. Best of all, you don't even need an app. Just click over to BlueHens.com on your device and take the Hens anywhere you go.
It really is a Blue Hens state of mind, and it's all about heading back to Baltimore to defend our crown. It's called March Madness for a reason. Your Blue Hens squad returns to Royal Farms Arena for the CAA Men's Basketball Championship, March 6th through March 9th. So much to see, so much to do. For the absolute best seats available to Blue Hen fans, visit BlueHens.com for more information.
Hello, Delaware fans. This is Coach Brock at beautiful Lums Pond State Park, just minutes from Delaware Stadium. I'm inviting you to come to the park, enjoy their year-round camping, boat rentals, equestrian center, and so much more. While you're here, experience the Go Ape Treetop Adventure. Go Ape is an outdoor experience where you can live life adventurously and experience the park from 50 feet up in the trees, hanging by a wire. To learn more about Go Ape or to book your visit to the course, visit www.goape.com. Go Hens!
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
We are the champions, setting it all forget. Oh, we on fire, we on fire. Running our own campaign, doing the whole shebang. Oh, we on fire, we on fire. Get up, stand up, throw your hands up. Welcome to the other land of dreamers, brothers, sisters, others. Yeah, we all fight like that.
My roots are 3,000 miles away, but now they are here in Newark. I won't let you down. You're my home crowd now. Experience it.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
My roots are 3,000 miles away, but now they are here in Newark. I won't let you down. You're my home crowd now. Experience it.
Hold on to me as we go. Just know you're not alone. I'm gonna make this place yours.
It really is a Blue Hen state of mind, and it's all about heading back to Baltimore to defend our crown. It's called March Madness for a reason. Your Blue Hen squad returns to Royal Farms Arena for the CAA Men's Basketball Championship, March 6th through March 9th. So much to see, so much to do. For the absolute best seats available to Blue Hen fans, visit BlueHens.com for more information.
We are the champions, setting it all forget. Oh, we on fire, we on fire. Running our own campaign, doing the whole shebang. Oh, we on fire, we on fire. Get up, stand up, throw your hands up. Welcome to the other land of dreamers, brothers.
brothers, sisters, others. Yeah, we all fight like that.
Hey fans, 12 and younger, do you want to be a future Blue Hen? Join the Future Hens Club presented by St. Francis Healthcare for invites to exclusive events and free admission to select UD games.
Meet coaches and players like us.
Get your official Future Hens t-shirt and more surprises.
To join, log on bluehens.com with a parent, click on Fan Zone, then Kids Club. Click Register Here, fill out your information, and click Submit.
Join today!
Rush hour or relax hour? It's your choice. Dark. Moving forward.
You can now watch all Hens All Access content on any of your devices. Whether you're at the store on your phone or on the couch with your iPad or laptop, Hens All Access live and on-demand content is just a touch away. Not only will live games be available on your mobile devices, they'll also be available in high definition. Best of all, you don't even need an app. Just click over to bluehens.com on your device and take the Hens anywhere you go.
It really is a Blue Hen state of mind, and it's all about heading back to Baltimore to defend our crown. It's called March Madness for a reason. Your Blue Hen squad returns to Royal Farms Arena for the CAA Men's Basketball Championship, March 6th through March 9th. So much to see, so much to do. For the absolute best seats available to Blue Hen fans, visit bluehens.com for more information.
Hello, Delaware fans. This is Coach Brock at beautiful Lums Pond State Park, just minutes from Delaware Stadium. I'm inviting you to come to the park, enjoy their year-round camping, boat rentals, equestrian center, and so much more. While you're here, experience the Go Ape Treetop Adventure. Go Ape is an outdoor experience where you can live life adventurously and experience the park from 50 feet up in the trees, hanging by a wire. To learn more about Go Ape or to book your visit to the course, visit www.goape.com. Go Hens!
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
We are the champions, setting it off again. Oh, we on fire, we on fire. Running our own campaign, doing the whole shebang. Oh, we on fire, we on fire. Get up, stand up, throw your hands up. Welcome to the other land of dreamers, brothers, sisters, others. Yeah, we all fight like that.
My roots are 3,000 miles away, but now they are here in Newark. I won't let you down. You're my home crowd now. Experience it.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
My roots are 3,000 miles away, but now they are here in Newark. I won't let you down. You're my home crowd now. Experience it.
Hold on to me as we go. Just know you're not alone.
cause I'm gonna make this place yours.
It really is a Blue Hen state of mind, and it's all about heading back to Baltimore to defend our crown. It's called March Madness for a reason. Your Blue Hen squad returns to Royal Farms Arena for the CAA Men's Basketball Championship, March 6th through March 9th. So much to see, so much to do. For the absolute best seats available to Blue Hen fans, visit BlueHens.com for more information.
Seeing her go to the well, but who else has to step up offensively?
As Coach Radice had said, Courtney Green and Hannah Jardine, points need to come from them too. They're going to start keying in on Erica Brown. It's going to be a difficult second half for her, but who else? Delaware needs to find someone else that's going to step up. Joy Caracciolo, maybe go inside. Hannah Jardine, step inside. And now that Hofstra zone is stretched out, allow them to work.
Second half will begin. Hofstra with a basketball moving left to right. They trail Delaware by four. Dribbling top of the circle, Luciano feeding right wing to Darius Falk. Falk around the perimeter, Loftus fires a three, curling off his screen, wouldn't go. Great box out by Caracciolo, but then she dropped the rebound, but went out of bounds off the foot of Eloetta Farolkin. As a result, back to Delaware. Hens will take that. Krista Kilburn-Stavesky, irate, thought that went off of Caracciolo, and I hate to agree, but I think I have to.
Looking for a foul, actually, on Joy Caracciolo from what she's saying, that she went over the back.
I thought it was a pretty good box out, no?
It was a great box out on Joy's part.
Green with it near wing, feeding top of the circle to Caracciolo, looking inside for Jardine, can't get it to her, dribbles towards the right elbow, hands it off to Taylor, who floats the top of the circle to Jardine, driving right side of the lane, banks it too strong off the window, rebound though, out of bounds off of Loftus, it'll stay with UD.
And Chastity Taylor right in there in the mix, forcing that loose ball to go Delaware's way.
Hens will take that active work here from the freshman on the offensive glass. Starters in for UD and for Hofstra. Near corner feed inside to Green. Green drives towards the lane. Kicks out to Jardine, top of the circle. Tried to pass left wing. No one was there. Good job to hold on to the ball. Now hands it off to Brown. Brown bounce pass right wing. Green dribbles towards the far quarter. Feeds up top Jardine. Left hand bounce towards the top. Now bad entry feed. Take it away. Luciano on the steal beats all of Delaware's defense back. Misses the uncontested layup and then does a good job to save it in bounds. Hofstra will reset, but that should have been an easy deuce. Cross-court feed, near wing, Loftus drives to the lane, dishes off to Etta Faroka, lefty finish on the block.
And Coach Radice talked about at halftime limiting the amount of times that Hofstra guards get into the lane. Right there, we saw a perfect example. Durant able to attack and find the open Hofstra player into the basket.
Brown, another high-arcing fadeaway jumper. This one wouldn't go. Caracciolo tying up Loftus on the board. That'll keep the ball with Delaware. 18:29 remaining in the second half. Lead is two for the Hens. They get a fresh 30 here. You're listening to Delaware Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 WWTX Wilmington, Delaware at 1410 WDOV Dover. Inbound goes to Caracciolo. Left block, hands it off to Taylor. Taylor bumped on her way up by Loftus. Loftus trying to take the charge, but did so in that restricted area. And as a result, the Hens will maintain possession. They'll say it's before the shot, so the inbound comes baseline left for UD. Second foul on Loftus. Inbound to Brown, who hits the jumper. Or excuse me, passes off to Jardine, who hits the jumper just right of the elbow. And it's a four-point UD edge. Hannah Jardine getting on the board after she had a quiet first half. Now crossover move to get in the lane. Falk fouled on her way up. A Euro step move as Caracciolo came and got a piece of her wrist. And as a result, two free throws coming here for Darius Falk. Nice little crossover, big step into the lane.
And that's a tough defensive play right there for Joy coming out to contest. Falk, just so athletic, is able to move her body to go into Joy Caracciolo.
Ugly looking lefty free throw, though. Push shot line drive goes off the back rim. One more coming. Out of the game goes Durant for Hofstra. Have to see who replaced her. Second free throw, line right, good. It's Sydney Epps, who did not play in that opening half. Epps in her 12th game of the season. Lead is three on the second free throw going through. Delaware on top. Brown picks up her bounce in the backcourt. Bad decision, and she's stripped as a result. Epps took it away, feeds it forward, and a layup for Loftus. And it's 29-28. Just can't pick up your bounce there. Brown does a good job to keep the dribble alive. This time as the trap comes. Back pass to Taylor into the middle of the floor to Jardine, who spins away from a trap. Dribbles towards the sideline, feeds it far corner. Taylor driving, reverse layup try, can't finish in tight. Offensive board, Caracciolo feeds at the foul line. Jardine, 15-footer, back rim, no. Green tipping at the loose ball, diving to the floor after it and scooping it to Jardine for a reset. Great hustle from Courtney Green. What a play, diving to the floor to keep it alive. Brown being bucked top of the circle, and a foul comes. Sydney Epps called for the personal. It'll be Epps first, team second. Sawyer back in. And to the bench goes Courtney Green for UD. Hens lead down to one. Delaware playing very hard in this game. As much hustle, I think, as we have seen from the Hens all year long. Rivalry game. Sawyer with it, right wing off the inbound. Bad pass up top. It goes into the backcourt. Violation gives it to Hofstra. Some sloppy mistakes, though, here, hurting Delaware in the early going.
Yeah, we're seeing the press, the Hofstra press right now, forcing Delaware into some bad decisions. And just right there, a simple entry pass to Erica Brown that was forced into the backcourt by Hofstra. Something that these are easy mistakes that Delaware could be correcting.
Speaking of easy mistakes, entry feed inside for Etta Faroka, too far to the baseline. Unforced air gives it right back to UD. So here come the Hens against this 1-2, 1-1 full court pressure. Sawyer and Brown, a catch in the backcourt. Now Brown off the bounce, bumped as she crossed the timeline, and a blocking foul called on Loftus. And three team fouls on Hofstra in less than 3 minutes so far in this second half. Inbound will come from Taylor near sideline, and that's the third foul on Loftus. As a result, she has to check out. Angie White will replace her. Taylor will trigger the inbound. Taylor's out there with Sawyer, Brown, Jardine, and Caracciolo. High post look here for UD. Some confusion as Caracciolo looks over at the bench, palms in the air. Now gets a feed right wing, dribbling aimlessly. I'm not sure Joy knows what set they're in. Still looking over at the bench for the play. Feeds it off to Brown, far corner to Sawyer. Sawyer looking inside for Joy. She gets it, double team, try to look opposite block. Taylor had to run down an errant pass. Now it ends up in the hands of Brown, over to Sawyer. Five on the shot clock. Jody drives baseline, floats it off the side of the backboard, and Etta Faroka grabs the rebound. Ugly set from UD that time. Here come the Pride racing the other way, weaving left, now right. Falk spinning into the lane, now back out towards the top of the key, and calls out an offensive set, lobs it inside to White, bumped by Caracciolo, good, and a foul. Pride back up by one with a free throw coming, as Hofstra beginning to play more like a team that's undefeated in league play so far.
We've seen the pace from Hofstra really pick up here in that second half. The defense is all over the Delaware guards right now. Delaware's offense, everyone on the Delaware offense right now seems very frazzled by the Hofstra guards. Delaware really needs to settle down and get into their offensive sets.
Caracciolo out, replaced by Leon, and the free throw missed, and over the back goes Hofstra. Big box out there from Hannah Jardine as they call the foul on Sydney Epps. Sydney Epps has played now a total of 2 minutes in this game, and she has two fouls, four and a half on the Pride. So Delaware ball, but now down by a point after they led by four at the break. A 7-2 spurt by Hofstra to start this second stanza. Brown dribbling near wing, feeds near corner to Taylor. Line drive jumper wouldn't go. Rebound batted around and finally corralled by Epps, who shows an elbow and then outlets it forward. Spinning the other way into the lane, Falk. Falk kicks it out left wing to Luciano. Up top, back to Falk. Falk, left hand bounce into the lane. She's a lefty. Feeds it back door off the hands of Jardine, who's looking for Etta Faroka. It'll stay with the Pride as it heads to the baseline. And we have a timeout on the floor. 15:55 left of the second half. Hofstra 30, Delaware 29. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 at 1410 WDOV.
Hey fans, 12 and younger, do you want to be a future Blue Hen? Join the Future Hens Club presented by St. Francis Healthcare for invites to exclusive events and free admission to select UD games.
Meet coaches and players like us.
Get your official Future Hens t-shirt and more surprises.
To join, log on bluehens.com with a parent, click on Fan Zone, then Kids Club. Click Register Here, fill out your information, and click Submit.
Join today!
My roots are 3,000 miles away, but now they are here in Newark. I won't let you down. You're my home crowd now. Experience it.
Today's broadcast table presented by Exxon and Shell. Delaware in a tight one with one of their biggest rivals, Hofstra. Hens trailing by a point after they led by four at the break. The lead has been as large as seven at one point for Delaware. Pride basketball out of this media timeout. The inbound will come from Angie White, baseline left. White will trigger in near corner at Efaroka. At Efaroka gets it right wing to Falk. Falk inside left block, backdoor cut, and a layup for Angie White. Delaware fell asleep defensively. Hens got to get re-engaged here. 9-2 spurt from Hofstra to take a three-point lead. Sawyer, cross-court feed, far sideline to Brown. Brown right wing to Green, up top to Brown. Around the perimeter, near wing, left side to Sawyer. Back to Brown, far wing Green for three. She's got it. Big triple for Courtney Green, ties this game. Boy, do the Hens need that, but they also needed to get back defensively. They did not. Lay up the other way for Angie White, or the great headman pass from Luciano.
And Delaware, that transition defense, Delaware needs to get back. That should be either Jody Salyer or Erica Brown. One of the guards should be rotating back as soon as that shot goes up.
Leon, high post, looks opposite, near wing. Green, front rim to three, hustled after it, tipped the loose ball, but Luciano stole it away from her. Outlets it forward to a sprinting Falk. Falk stopped at the foul line by Brown. Good transition defense that time for the Hens, and Hofstra has to set up a half-court chance. Left wing over to Luciano, driving baseline, threw it away, but it ends up in the hands of Falk. Falk driving to the lane, out to White, left of the lane, jumper, no, rebound tipped out of bounds by Brown. Brown tangles up with Epps, and it goes out of bounds off the Hens, back to Hofstra. They'll call a foul, actually, on Erica Brown. They'll say that she grabbed the shoulder of Sydney Epps, and that actually is probably a good call, as Caracciolo will return. Leon out for Delaware. Again, our apologies, Steph Leon. The proper pronunciation we learned, not Steph Leone, as we've been calling her for the last several years. Inbound, tipped out of bounds by a hustling Caracciolo. It'll stay with Hofstra. 29 should be on the timer. They'll keep it at 30. That ball came inbounds and was tipped. 14:39 left second half. Lob inbound goes left wing to Falk, and Falk will set things up, dribbling towards the top of the key, picking up her bounce. Right wing chest pass over to Epps. Epps leaves her feet, lobs it inside at Efaroka, powers up, but walked before she let go of the shot. And up off the bench, Tina Martin and Janine Radice almost had a conniption over there to try to get that travel call. And finally, the officials oblige.
And a great job by Hannah Jardine and Joy Caracciolo collapsing on Ekafor right there and making that a difficult shot.
Jardine top of the key for three. It's good. And ends back up by a point, 35-34. Big triple from Hannah Jardine, who's shooting almost 50% from deep on the year. If Green and Jardine get going, look out. Right wing Falk for Hofstra the other way. Tries to split the middle of the zone. Left wing feed over to Luciano. Far corner to Epps. Epps to the left elbow. Pull up jumper, no. Weak side rebound. Hustled down by Jardine. Outlets it to Sawyer looking to run. Jody pushes. Feeds it forward. Brown on the baseline. Stops and pops for a jumper. In and out. Rebound tipped. Green hustling and tying up Angie White. And a technical foul called on White. As White threw Green to the floor, and Delaware will take it as they're going to get some free throws out of this. We told you it was starting to get chippy. The officials had to gain control. One team or the other was going to pay, and that time it was Hofstra on what I thought was just good hard basketball. We'll see. Looked like to me they were tied up. Green and White's just a little bigger, and as a result, as White let go. She kind of nudged her a little, maybe. Maybe a little nudge.
There was an extra shove there at the end of that. We had a pretty good angle on that mat. But a great job by Courtney Green, hustling all over the floor. Angie White, 6'2". Courtney Green at all of maybe 5'7", right in there in the post right now, getting rebounds, hustling after plays.
So Green to the line to shoot two here for the technical. Krista Kilburn, Stavesky out the midcourt asking why. But as Lauren described, a little extra nudge. Green hits the first free throw. One more and then it'll be Delaware ball.
And this is right now where Delaware needs to keep their cool. This is Hofstra's type of game. They like to get in your head. As we've seen in previous years with Hofstra, Matt, this is their type of game. They're going to knock you all over the floor. They're going to talk. They have a lot of things to say. This young Delaware team needs to keep their composure in the next few minutes here.
Boy, giving Krista Kilburn-Stavesky a lot of leeway here. She was out at center court arguing her case, still in a debate with the official who called the technical foul. So Delaware ball, though. Off the technical foul with Green making both free throws. The lead three for UD. Sire looking to get it in. Finds Green. Head fake. One dribble. Baseline jumper wouldn't go. Right rim and off the mark. Rebound Durant. Outlets it forward. Great feed ahead of the pack to Luciano. Let the defense clear but then missed the layup. And Green, who's everywhere, hustles up the floor to grab the rebound. Outlets it to Sire, who drives in the lane then circles out near center court.
What a job by Courtney Green and Jody Salyer to get down the floor there and transition and stop that transition break by Luciano.
Jardine left wing with it for UD. Up top to Sire. Sire on the right wing. Jab step move, driving into the lane. Lobs it inside. Caracciolo lays it home. What a feed from Sire. Hens by five, 13 minutes left.
What a play. Jody Salyer to Joy Caracciolo. You really can't. Even diagram a play any better than that with the screen and roll. A perfect play right there.
And Efaroka forces a 15-footer, wouldn't go. Rebound grabbed by Durant. Durant's follow good. And Hofstra back to within three. What a feed, though, by Sire. Middle of the lane, just inside the free throw line. Lobbing it right block over top of a tall defender, and Efaroka. Perfect touch on that pass. Here's Sire, top of the circle. Out near center court. Now left wing feed to Green. Green, left hand bounce towards the baseline. Spinning back towards the foul line. Out left wing to Caracciolo. Right wing over to Sire. Five on the timer. Jody inside to Caracciolo. Scoops it up and in. Kissing it home from just outside the right block. Delaware regains the five-point lead.
And those big shots from Courtney Green, from Hannah Jardine right now on the outside, has opened up that lane and giving Joy Caracciolo room to work inside.
All about creating space, which Delaware has done. The right block spinning. Durant working on Caracciolo. Got the shot up. Couldn't get it to go. Jardine kind of twisted her ankle there. She grabbed the rebound, but seems to be all right. Did a nice job to hold her balance and find Sire, who walks it up. Bench asks Jardine if she's okay. She nods, saying she is. So we play on as Sawyer dribbles towards the top. Now angling to the right wing. Looking inside for Caracciolo. That's taken away. Up top, Green. Head fake to three. Left hand bounce into the lane. Scoops it up and good. How'd she get that shot off? Around Durant. Hens up seven. Equaling the largest lead of the game for UD. What a finish from Courtney Green. Here's Loftus in the lane. Right wing feed over to Durant, lefty finish, try wouldn't go, follow at Efaroka, good, and a foul. Over top of Caracciolo, who gave the contact. And a chance for the old-fashioned three-point play coming for Hofstra when we return. The Delaware has opened up a five-point edge. 11-11 left to go from the Carpenters Center. Delaware 43, Hofstra 38. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOP.
Hello, Delaware fans. This is Coach Brock at beautiful Lums Pond State Park, just minutes from Delaware Stadium. I'm inviting you to come to the park, enjoy their year-round camping, boat rentals, equestrian center, and so much more. While you're here, experience the Go Ape Treetop Adventure. Go Ape is an outdoor experience where you can live life adventurously and experience the park from 50 feet up in the trees, hanging by a wire. To learn more about Go Ape or to book your visit to the course, visit www.goape.com. Go Hens!
Hold on to me as we go. Just know you're not alone.
cause I'm gonna make this place yours.
Welcome back to the Bob. What a game this has been. 11-11 left to go in the second half. Delaware up 43-38. It's been back and forth. Hens have led by as many as seven twice. Hofstra has had as large a lead as six. Right now the edge is five, but one free throw coming for the sophomore, Elo Edeforoka, the Nigerian native for this Hofstra team. Try to pull the Pride back to within four. It's been physical. It's been well contested. And it has been spirited. As the free throw good, making it 43-39. At Eforoka to the bench for a breather. D. Thomas Palmer replacing her. It's everything you would think a rivalry would be. You've played in this game before. You know emotions are going to run high.
Absolutely, and this is the point in the game where Delaware needs to keep their composure. You have five young players on the floor right now. Keep your head about you and just play the way you've been playing.
Jardine, top of the circle, got it inside of Leon. Back to Jardine, pass tip, but into the hands of Sawyer. Sawyer driving towards the foul line, lobs it inside. Jardine, turn and face, elbow jumper wouldn't go. Rebound corralled by Luciano, looking to run. Three on three. Luciano stops at the foul line. Shot blocked from behind by Green. What a block by Courtney. Brown out of there with the ball, looking to run. No numbers, so she throws things up. Crossing over, left wing towards the top, being bumped the whole way, and the call finally came. Darius Falk called for the personal. That's the sixth team foul already on Hofstra. So the Hens will shoot the rest of the way, and there's still 10:32 to go. Plus, that's the third foul on Falk.
And now Erica Brown being defended, going over the top of that screen by Falk. Falk not able to get over there, and now she's fouling Erica Brown. Erica Brown still giving Delaware opportunities here.
Inbound to Leon, top of the circle, hands it off there to Brown. Brown dribbling towards the right wing, between the legs with the bounce, hands it off to Sawyer, foul line right. Jody dribbling towards the corner, weaves hand off to Brown. Brown started towards the top, now crosses over, driving baseline, offensive foul. Just no space for Brown to operate, needed to circle back outside. Instead, taking the charge was Luciano. Third foul on Brown, and that's something, if you're the Hens, you can't like. Brown's had a very solid game, second in a row for UD.
With the way Erica Brown's been playing, I would say that the Delaware coaching staff's going to leave her in right now. She's an experienced sophomore point guard. Why not take your chances on her?
And you're right. They leave her in. Hofstra with the ball. D. Thomas Palmer trying to drive baseline on the right block. Kicks it opposite wing to Jackson. Jackson foul line back to Thomas Palmer. Her jumper wouldn't go. Offensive board up from Epps. Put back try. No, but she was fouled. Who's this on? Jody Sawyer called for the personal. That'll be Sawyer's second. And the team sixth. And buckle in. It's going to be a long final 9:55. Every foul the rest of the way will send each team to the line.
Yeah, and Delaware right now up, but Hofstra's not down yet. You can never count Hofstra out. They're a team that likes to fight. They're going to keep themselves in the game. No matter how they're going to keep themselves in the game, they're going to stay they're going to stay in the game.
Epps back rim the first free throw. Makeda Nicholas in for the first time in this second half. Epps misses the second. She follows after it, but bumped Jardine, and Hannah's going to walk the length, and Delaware will take that. Their best free throw shooter will go to the stripe for 1-1. She's 89% on the season.
Ladies and gentlemen, the University of Delaware is now in
the bowl. So Jardine, 6'1 sophomore out of New Finland, Canada. They did a feature on her, BlueHens.com. Maggie Hayon with a good job on that. You can check it out online as she hits the first free throw, so she'll get another. They asked her what her bucket list entails. And top of the list, represent Canada in the Olympics. It's a pretty lofty goal. My bucket list is like go see another country. Hers is represent her. Second free throw good, so the lead is 6, 45-39 with 9:54 to go in the second half. But you like that, and that's what makes her such a special player. She's a hard worker. Tina Martin saying you won't find anybody that's going to give more effort in this program than Hannah Jardine. Bringing it forward, Loftus, top of the circle to Luciano. Back to Loftus for three straight away. Back rim, no. Rebound tipped by Anna Faroka. Nicholas tackled her, no call, and she gets the rebound. It's getting physical, but they're swallowing the whistles here of late after not doing much of that early. And Sawyer will walk it up. Jody Sawyer near wing. Bounce pass top of the circle, Leon. Leon looking. Now the point guard comes and gets the basketball from her. Sawyer right wing feed over to Jardine. High post to Nicholas. One dribble. Up and under move. Turnaround jumpers. A switch. Nice ball move there from Makeda Nicholas. The freshman gives Delaware its largest lead of the night.
And we haven't seen much of Makeda Nicholas in the second half, but continuing the way she played in the first half, making great reads right there. She saw that she had space between her and her man, pulled up and took that jump shot.
Luciano, far corner feed, and Loftus hits a three, and Krista Kilburn-Stavesky wants to take a timeout to adjust defensively. That'll get it to a five-point game. Tina Martin not real happy about the way the Hens played defensively there. And we will take the timeout with the Pride. Delaware 47, Hofstra 42, 8:49 left to go in the second half. You're listening to Blue Hens Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOB.
Welcome to the other land of dreamers, brothers, sisters, others. Yeah, we all fight like that.
You can now watch all Hens All Access content on any of your devices. Whether you're at the store on your phone or on the couch with your iPad or laptop, Hens All Access live and on-demand content is just a touch away. Not only will live games be available on your mobile devices, they'll also be available in high definition. Best of all, you don't even need an app. Just click over to BlueHens.com on your device and take the Hens anywhere you go.
.849 left to go, second half, 47-42. Delaware's lead is five. It has been exactly what you would think of a young team, Lauren. This Hens team, sometimes they look like world beaters. Other times you wonder how they're ever going to score a basket again. It's been a roller coaster, but right now it's a high. They've played very well tonight.
Overall, they've played a very good game. We've seen a couple minutes here and there where they went back to that similar to the team we saw against the College of Charleston, against Eastern Carolina earlier this season. But right now they're playing very well.
Executing at a high clip. Erica Brown tries to thread the needle with a pass. It's tipped away by two different Hofstra players and stolen. Asia Jackson off to the races, wins it to the basket, beating Leon back and laying it home with the left hand. And that quickly, it's back to a three-point game. And all of a sudden now starting to press a little bit the last couple of trips. Sawyer picking up her bounce, right elbow feed to Nicholas, attacking off the bounce and putting it home with the left hand. Nine-footer straight away in the lane. Nice finish from Nicholas. Under eight left to go. Hens lead back to five. Right wing Loftus up top between the circles to Durant. Around the perimeter, left wing to Jackson. Cross court feed near wing Luciano. Into the corner to Loftus, who dribbles towards the wing. Back towards the corner now. Fires up a triple, wouldn't go. Weak side rebound. Sawyer and Jackson, a tie up. And they go sprawling to the floor. They both wanted that loose ball. The arrow will keep it with Hofstra. And we have a timeout on the floor. It'll be Pride ball when we come back. 7:40 left to go in the second half. Two rivals standing toe-to-toe in the center of the ring, throwing haymakers. Delaware 49, Hofstra 44. You're listening to Blue Hens Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
Rush hour or relax hour? It's your choice. Dark. Moving forward.
My roots are 3,000 miles away, but now they are here in Newark. I won't let you down. You're my home crowd now. Experience it.
.740 left to go in the second half. Delaware on top by five. Score is 49-44. Hens have led by as many as eight here this evening. Blue Hen basketball being brought to you by Cockard Pet Food and Supplies. For everything your pet needs, visit CockardPetFoods.com or any of their 27 locations in the area. Hofstra ball out of the media timeout. They lob an inbound to Darius Falk out near center court. She dribbles towards the left elbow. Now backs up to the wing, that side of the floor. Top of the circle, give to Jackson. Jackson left wing, chest pass over to Loftus. Loftus right hand bounce right of the lane, bumped on her way towards the basket. And a foul will send her to the line for a 1-1. Steph Leon called for the foul. Her first, team seven. So 1-1 coming for Loftus, who's not a great free throw shooter, 68% on the season. 5'10 sophomore out of Alexandria, Virginia, misses the front end, but then Green tipped the rebound right to Edda Faroka, who missed a point-blank layup try and then goes over the back on Makeda Nicholas. And so now Delaware will walk the length of the floor for a 1-1 the other way. How did that layup not go in, as Edda Faroka had it and really was uncontested, just couldn't bank it home. So now Nicholas, a 1-1. She's a 54% free throw shooter, but 2 of 2 tonight. Line left here, trying to extend Delaware's 5-point lead, and she can't do it. In and out. Rebound corralled after Hannah Jardine went sprawling to the floor by Darius Falk. Falk feeds it forward. Jackson shot rejected by Nicholas. Sire ends up with it, looking to run, but Tina Martin imploring her to slow things up, so the redshirt sophomore point guard will. Boy, Makeda Nicholas sending some shots to the seats. Here's a foul away from the ball. A hold caught on Darius Falk. And that should be Falk's fourth foul. It is. Her fourth, team's ninth. Courtney Green to the line for a 1-1. And Green's exactly who you want at the line. A 76% free throw shooter for the front end. As Falk has to go out, back in comes Luciano for Hofstra.
And we had a pretty clean look at that one right in front of us there, Matt. Both hands on her and just shot there straight to the floor.
With a little hip check thrown into
Absolutely.
Boot.
Absolutely.
First free throw good for Green. She gets one more here, line left. Chance to get the lead back to seven, and she does. Swishes a pair, which is a good sign for Green, and need her confidence to return in her shot. Seems like it has a bit here in the second
Courtney
half.
Courtney Green absolutely coming back into her shot, into herself right now. From what we've seen the last couple games, really struggling, but absolutely no hesitation tonight in letting the ball fly.
7-point deficit here for Hofstra. They try to go to work at a half court. The Delaware product, White goes inside, misses a lefty hook, and a Faroka's follow, too strong off the glass, and a foul called here on Sager, fighting inside with a much bigger Edda Faroka. And that should be Jody Sager's third, team's eighth, and it means a 1-1 here for Edda Faroka. Hannah Jardine took a shot to the left eye. Looks like maybe a contact lens loose for Jardine, who's going to run over to the bench. Get that taken care of. You get the 20 seconds here, and Jardine, who's had a strong stretch of basketball, I think they might have to make a sub here, as they got the contact solution ready as fast as they could. Now we're just in a holding pattern, so I guess they're going to give her a little leeway to stay in the game. And Faroka has not done much tonight. I think Delaware has done a really good job for her. You wondered coming in, how would that matchup work? It's worked out pretty well. They have contained her, they forced her to work for everything, and they frustrated her so badly. She has now missed two essentially uncontested layups because she's rushing things.
Yeah, Delaware collapsing in on the paint every time she catches the basketball. Hannah Jardine, Joy Caracciolo, Makeda Nicholas doing a very good job at closing off her lanes and closing off her options. And then the guards doing a great job at getting out on the open shooters.
As it turns out, Jardine couldn't get the contact lens all the way in, so she has to go out. Brown returns. First free throw, no good. Another front end miss for Hofstra. It's tipped out of bounds, and it goes back to UD. Up seven with 6:28 to go. Well, I don't wear contact lenses. You do. How tough is it to try to get a contact lens in under the gun in like 20 seconds to stay in the game?
It's very difficult, especially when you're in the heat of the moment and your hands are shaking. You just want to get back in the game. It's a tough thing to do.
I can't imagine doing it under regular circumstances. As Jardine, we'll see how long she's out for. Green with it, the forecourt, handing it off to Leon straight away. Back near center court to Brown. 10 on the timer, left hand bounce for Erica towards the wing, near side of the floor. Now to the foul line off a high screen from Leon, missed it. Offensive board, Nicholas, follow, wouldn't go. It was partially blocked. Leon fighting for the loose ball, out of bounds off of Hofstra. Last touch by Angie White. Delaware ball with a French 30, up by 7, under 6 minutes left to go. Back in for the Pride, D. Thomas Palmer will replace Ed Afaroku, who's just had a miserable night here this evening. Krista Kilburn-Stavesky telling her sophomore, keep your head up as she goes over to the bench. Inbound Green, turn and fire. Shot rattles around that in. Hit every part of the rim, maybe even twice. It's the largest lead of the game for Delaware, up 9. 5 3/4 minutes, all that separates the Hens from a second straight CAA win.
And it's pretty safe to say that Courtney Green looks like she is back. She's back to herself again, shooting the ball confidently.
And grabs the rebound on the right wing miss from Jackson. Weak side board hustled down in the corner by Green on a forced three from Hofstra. And Delaware will slow things up. Ahead by 9, looking for the first double-digit lead for either team tonight. Sawyer, right wing feed, top of the circle to Leon. Hand off to Brown. Brown dribbling left wing. High screen from Leon, doesn't use it. Tries to go baseline, now turns back to the top. 3 on the timer, crossover move to the foul line. Can't free herself up, gets it off to Leon, whose shot came late, didn't go anyway. Violation will give it back to Hofstra. Little too much bounce that time from Erica Brown.
Erica Brown really trying to make something happen right there at the shot clock going down. She thought she had the baseline side, but with Stephanie Leon at 6'4", you want to use that screen, especially with the shot clock going down, and with how well her shot's been falling tonight, use that screen and go off of it.
And Tina Martin tells her sophomore point guard exactly that as she comes out, replaced by Jardine, but you don't think this absence will be very long for the game for Erica Brown. Far wing, Asia Jackson on the dribble, feeding between the rings to Falk. Falk towards the foul line, spinning into the lane, and walked as she split a double team. Good defense from Sawyer and Leon, a small little crevice, and she just couldn't fit through without dragging the pivot. Delaware gets it back up 9, 4:46 to go.
Jody Sawyer really hanging tough tonight in that back line. Normally up at the top, a completely different situation in that back line. She's really getting everything that these Hofstra post players have tonight.
Green doubled as she gets it into the forecourt. Back pass out near center court to Sawyer. Sawyer dribbling far sideline near the bench. Up top to Green. Green, high screen from Leon, turns the corner off of it. Lefty finish, off balance, wouldn't go. Nicholas crashes the glass, but tipped it to the baseline, and that'll give it back to Hofstra. Delaware is crashing the glass with reckless abandon tonight as Brown returns Jardine out, and they're keeping a lot of balls alive for second chances.
Yeah, the coaches, since Sunday, the coaches did something here to get these Delaware players motivated to attack the offensive glass. That must have been something that they went over in their pregame scout.
Tina Martin was begging us, or her team through us in the pregame interview, we've got an offensive board, and they have tonight. Inside, Ed Afaroku with it on the left block, turning around on Leon, stripped all the way up. Sawyer came over digging and got a little piece of the wrist of Ed Afaroku, who struggled at the strike. That's Sawyer's fourth, team's ninth, but it's in the act. Two free throws coming here. 4:07 left. Delaware up 53-44. Been a rough night at the free throw line for Ed Afaroku. First foul shot, up and no good. Back rimmed it, her fifth miss of the night from the stripe.
A rough night for Hofstra tonight in general from the free throw line.
Out goes Sawyer, in comes Jardine. 4:07 remaining. Delaware trying to get back to 2-3 in conference play. Foul shot no good. Offensive rebound though grabbed by Hofstra. And Durant fouled on the putback try by Leon. And she will shoot a pair. Delaware continuing to have issues boxing out on missed free throws. We saw it pretty consistently against Northeastern and Towson. And now coming here late tonight. Ashanae Durant for two free throws now as Delaware in the double bonus. Both teams are, as a matter of fact. First free throw good for Durant, who's 76% from the stripe on the season. her first trip to the line of the night. As a team, Hofstra 4 of 14, but they hit a pair here. 5 of 15, that's hideous. 33%, one of the big reasons why they're down by 7. As Nicholas goes out, Caracciolo returns, and the Hens trying to close this one out and get in the winner's circle again. Pressure back for Hofstra. 1-2-1-1. Brown right side of the floor. Back near side, Green dribbling across the timeline. Lost it out of bounds to Hofstra. Not stripped, just flat lost control of the bounce. Turnover gives it back to the Pride. It'll be their ball when we return. 3:54 left to go of the second half. It's Delaware 53, Hofstra 46. Back with more Blue Hens basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV in a moment.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
Rush hour or relax hour? It's your choice. Dark. Moving forward.
My roots are 3,000 miles away, but now they are here in Newark. I won't let you down. You're my home crowd now. Experience it.
This is incredible.
.354, all that separates Delaware from a second straight victory. They lead Hofstra 53-46. Pride ball, though, out of the media timeout. Courtney Green in there, top of the zone with Erica Brown. Sawyer, Leon, and Caracciolo on the back line. Dribbling left wing for the Pride, it's Falk. Falk with four fouls, spins into the lane, kicks it out near wing Jackson. Far corner, cross-court feed goes to King Gilchrist, who walked. Head faked and then dragged the pivot foot. She's not played much tonight. She's not a big rotation guy for Hofstra. In late, makes a critical mistake as defense for offense. Caracciolo goes out, Jardine returns for UD. Maybe not defense for offense, but Jardine back in. Maybe they're looking for an extra guard here against the pressure. I would certainly think Caracciolo known more for her offense than her defense over the course of her Delaware career.
Breaking this Hofstra press would be very difficult with both Stephanie Leone and Joy Caracciolo. A very good move right there by the Delaware coaching staff.
Good point. Brown, center of the floor to Sawyer. Good feed to Leon. Near corner, wide open, triple Green. Got it! Hens by 10. First time either team has led by double digits all night. Textbook press break for UD. Now a forced three the other way. Loftus can't hit. Brown the rebound, and this one looking good for UD. 10-point edge with the ball. 3 minutes left on the clock. Brown, right side of the floor, between the rings to Green. Left-hand bounce towards the baseline. Now out to the wing. Driving baseline. Finishes with the left hand. What a second half for Courtney Green. A dozen-point Delaware lead. Timeout Hofstra. And a Bob Faithful rises to its feet as the Hens see Hofstra try to crawl back in it. And Courtney Green may have just shut the door. Courtney Green with confidence. What a press break. Center of the floor, Sire to Leon, and then a great feed from Steph to a wide open Courtney Green.
And when Courtney Green caught that ball, there was no hesitation. She caught that ball, stepped into her shot, and let it fly. The Courtney Green that we saw in the beginning of the season when she was putting up 18, 16 points a night. A perfect, perfect shot right there from her.
And you wondered, what, would she pull the trigger? She's been a little hesitant. Late game. You're up 7 with the ball, under 3 minutes to go. But as Janine Redis said to us at the half, shooters have to shoot. Courtney Green pulled the trigger, 100% the right decision. And boy, did it pay off. And then the layup to add to it. 12-point Delaware edge. As this Blue Hen team, perhaps this young group, has learned how to close games down the stretch. Something happened in Boston that provided a lift, and now playing in front of the home faithful. Driving baseline out of the media timeout. Asia Jackson can't convert in tight, and Jardine, the weak side rebound for UD. 2:30 left, Hens by 12 with the ball. Brown prancing her way across the midcourt stripe. Bounce pass between the rings to Green. Left wing on the bounce with the right hand. Looking inside for Leon. Now calling for some movement. Brown comes over to get the ball, but a bad pass. Steal and a foul on Brown. Not sure whether Green thought Brown was going to keep coming to her or whatever the miscommunication there was. Turnover will give it back to the Pride and allow Hofstra to score with the clock stopped. Two free throws coming. Fourth foul on Brown and double bonus time for the Pride. So at the line here, Darius Falk. We mentioned 10 missed free throws in the game for Hofstra. They're at 33% as a team. First foul shot. My gosh, it almost missed everything. No good. One more coming. Hofstra has their sights set on a top two finish in the CAA this year. They better improve at the stripe if they're going to do it. Second free throw is good. 11-point game, 58-47. More pressure for the Pride. Sawyer lobs it into Jardine. Jardine trapped, threw it away. Stolen by Falk. Falk barrels into Sawyer, called for the offensive foul. Jody Sawyer went offense to defense in the blink of an eye. Falk is fouled out, and Delaware has the ball back up 11. My goodness, what a turn and what a play from Jody Sawyer.
Jody Sawyer taking a number of hits in that back line tonight, getting everything from those Hofstra post players. Playing as a guard in that back line is a very difficult thing to do. Jody Sawyer holding her own right there and taking a big shot on that charge.
You wonder if she'll be able to hold up. Not the biggest player. 5'10", has height, but in terms of physical build, she's stronger than you give her credit for, but she just isn't somebody that you would expect to be able to take that kind of pounding from this type of size all year long, but right now it sure is working.
Absolutely, and Jody Sawyer is one of those players that has the drive, the internal drive that's going to push her in games. She might not be able to out-jump a player, she might not be able to be physically stronger than somebody, but she's going to push herself, she's going to give you all she can.
And she definitely has the intestinal fortitude to do it. That was one heck of a charge take there. As the Hens will throw it in now. Sawyer gets it in far corner to Brown. Brown being bumped. Brown being fouled. And Brown will head to the line to shoot two. With 2:07 to go. The lead at 11 for Delaware. And if the Hens make free throws and do not turn the ball over, this one's over. And the Hens will get their seventh victory of the season. Brown line left. Two foul shots coming here. She had a huge first half for this Delaware team. Really carried the Hens. Had 14 points at the break on 6 of 7 shooting. Front rims the first free throw. She'll get one more here. Get one. 2:07 left on the clock. Brown puts it through. 59-47, lead back to a dozen for Delaware. Hofstra racing the other way. Jackson near corner. Fires on the wing to Durant. Durant out to Luciano, whose three is good. And it's back to a single-digit game, 59-50, 1:59 left on the clock. Timeout Hofstra, they have two left.
And Hofstra has three players on the floor right now that shoot over 35% from the three-point line. You don't want to give them those open looks. We've seen games that Delaware has been in that have closed very quickly because of them allowing the three-point shot. So Delaware really needs to lock down on defense right here.
If you're Hofstra, how long do you wait before you go for the foul? You've had some success turning Delaware over, but it's been limited success. The Hens have handled the pressure pretty well, at least until the last minute or two. It's a kind of a math equation. You're under 2 minutes, down by nine. You can't afford to wait too long, but at the same time, you'd love a steal. How long do you go for?
I would say they may be going as to who gets the basketball to foul right now, or else they may just play this possession out. There's still 2 minutes left.
Well, that'd be tough. The timeout called by Delaware in the backcourt. Beg your pardon, by the way, Hofstra only one timeout left. Now with that TO, the Hens have two remaining. 1:59 left, and you see coaches, they will do that. They will play it out from time to time. I'm the old school Jim Valvano, extend the game, foul and see what happens, particularly with some Delaware players out there that aren't the world's greatest free throw shooters. You don't want to foul Hannah Jardine. To me, at a 59-50 game,
worst case scenario for Delaware, you hold the ball for 30 seconds. I mean, Hofstra, if you play this one out, even if you get a stop, you're still down three possessions, three threes, plus no more points for Delaware with under 90 seconds to go. That's an awful tall hill to try to climb.
If Delaware, if they go about 15 seconds, Delaware holding the basketball right now, Hofstra's going to have to follow. I don't think Hofstra's going to allow this 30-second shot clock to run out right now. They don't have enough time to get back within the game in 9 points.
So Sawyer again will try to trigger it inbounds, running the baseline, finds Brown. Brown pawed at, no call. Back pass, dangerous, great dribble to tip it by Sawyer to Leon, but then Leon tied up. Delaware needs to get the ball away from underneath their own basket. Possession arrow does belong to UD, but that was about as dangerous a pass as you're going to see.
Delaware cannot keep going back and forth between Erica Brown and Jody Sawyer. They cannot play catch in the backcourt with these Hofstra guards. They need to get the ball up the floor.
Threw it near sideline to underneath their own basket. Yeah. Inbound goes to Brown again in the corner. Double team, threw it off of a Hofstra player. 22 on the timer. Good news is you get 10 seconds every time the ball goes out of bounds. A fresh 10 to get it across. 1:51 remaining in the game. 59-50. Stationary inbound. Oh, Sawyer walked. They didn't call it. Sawyer ran the baseline and got it inbounds. And now the clock did not start to run initially. Oh. Krista Kilburn-Stavesky. I don't know what she's upset about. You get a fresh 10 to get it across when the ball goes out of bounds.
She was upset about Jody's.
I thought she was pointing at the clock.
No.
I mean, it was a clear walk. Delaware got away with one. It's a stationary inbound, and Sawyer took two full steps to the left, but it works for UD. I don't know how you missed that, though, if you're an official. He just pointed at the ground that it's a stationary inbound.
He hands the ball to Sawyer,
and next thing you know, she sprints away. And now they go to the monitor not to look at the walk. They can't reverse that, but to look at the clock. The clock never started. Well, that's rough if you're Hofstra. 1:51 remaining now. They'll move 2 seconds off. It's also rough for Delaware because they had finally broken the pressure. And now they'll have to throw it in, probably just inside of the half-court stripe. Meanwhile, clock just keeps burning away here, slowly but surely. It's taken about 5 minutes to run 6 seconds, but every second counts when you have a 9-point lead and there's under 2 minutes
left. Very slowly. We went through about three possessions there where Hofstra forced Delaware either to take a timeout or they tipped the basketball out of bounds. Delaware really needs to be smart with the basketball underneath that basket. Hofstra's guards, too athletic, too quick to be making to be hesitating on decisions right now.
Coming up after this one is done, the American Spirit post-game show. It's brought to you by the American Spirit Federal Credit Union in Newark, Middletown, and Dover. They're also online at americanspirit.org. Delaware women's basketball also being brought to you by the Glasgow Medical Aid Units, making a difference one patient at a time over 60,000 times a year with locations in Glasgow, Christiana, and Middletown. Same time, save money, get well. Visit them online at glasgowmedicalcenter.com. Also by our friends at Capriotti's Sandwich Shop, which is a proud supporter of Delaware basketball. Stop into Capriotti's at the Newark Shopping Center or at 4422 Kirkwood Highway to pick up trays for any of your party needs, including that big game that's coming up in a couple of weeks. Capriotti's.com for more information. 1:51 left second half. Delaware 59, Hofstra 50. They're having to adjust the clock here. Always unfortunate, though, when you're the team, you know you just got away with one, and the officials go over to the monitor to look at it because they see how badly they missed that call, and now you know they should be at least looking for a makeup call. That's what I would do if I were an official. I just butchered a call that badly. I'd be looking to give it back to the team that should have the ball.
Delaware needs to be very careful with what they do here. No silly fouls, especially offensive fouls. They just need to take care of the basketball.
19 on the shot clock, 1:48 on the game clock. And Sawyer will throw it in just inside the midcourt stripe. Hens moving right to left in the second half with the ball up by 9. Inbound will go into the backcourt to Erica Brown, and the Hens now will run some clock. Hofstra going to play it out. Wide foul here. Leon with it between the rings. Near baseline feed to Green. Green angling towards the wing. High screen from Leon. Turns the corner of the foul line. Steps back. Right elbow jumper. Back rim no. Rebound corralled by White. But only 90 seconds left of the clock. Here comes Hofstra. They better hurry. Left wing, Luciano feeds top of the circle to Jackson. Hofstra acting like it's a walk in the park in no hurry whatsoever. Edda Faroka inside, backing up on Leon. A hand check foul called on Steph Leon. Maybe that makeup
that
call we
makeup
were talking
call
about.
We were looking for.
Small change. They called nickel dimer. That one was pennies. That was no contact whatsoever. Wasn't even an arm ball. Two free throws coming for Edda Faroka. You're going to give a makeup call. That's not a bad person to put at the line.
Not at all with the way. I mean, really, anyone for Hofstra you could probably put at the line, shooting only 30% right now from the free throw line. You could probably pick and choose if you're Delaware.
11 free throws they have missed in this game. Make it 12 as Ed Faroka misses badly. Hofstra's confidence has just evaporated from the charity stripe. One more free throw, 9-point Delaware lead, 75 seconds left. Ed Faroka puts a line drive through that time. It's 59-51. The good news for Hofstra, that allows him to set up the pressure. The full court look, 1-2-1-1, face guarding on the inbound. They lob it into Leon. Leon hands it off to Sawyer. Sawyer over the top to Brown. Brown dribbling backwards, three to get it across. Should use a timeout here, over to Sawyer. And Delaware gets it, even though they did not have possession. Woo-hoo. One official called 10 seconds. The other signaled timeout. And when they blew the whistle, Delaware did not have the basketball. So we'll see what they end up going with here. If the Hens get this call, Krista Kilburn-Stavesky is going to lose it. And they don't get the call. 10-second violation. Turnover for Delaware. That is the Hens' 20th turnover of the night. Boy, how do you have an 8-point lead with 20 giveaways? Incredible from the Hens, the grittiness they've shown defensively. I didn't realize it was that many. Did you?
I didn't think it was either.
We lost stats for a little while courtside here. I think that's a good call on the no timeout. It didn't seem to me like they had possession when the whistle blew. Hofstra today, 6 of 18 from 3. They need to go fast. Minute to go on the inbound. Again, taking their time. Lob inside. Leon got away with a shove. The ball tipped out to Jackson. Front rims a corner three. Jardine the rebound. And it's looking good for Delaware now. Brown gets the pass. She's fouled in the backcourt. And Erica Brown will head to the stripe for free throws. Brown, 2 of 4 from the line today, but better than 75% from the stripe of the season. Hens 13 of 17 as a team. Hofstra 8 of 20. One of the big differences. The other, though, flat out has been defense. First free throw, no good. So Hofstra, the hope, faint, but stays alive. Delaware has held the Pride to 31% shooting from the field. As Loftus will return, replacing Durant here for Hofstra. One more free throw for Brown to try and make this a 9-point game. 49 and 9-10 seconds remaining on the clock. Second foul shot up and good. Here comes Hofstra. Now they need to hurry. Jackson racing towards the basket. Step back. Deep too good. And a timeout called by Hofstra, their last timeout. It's a 7-point game. You know what, though? If you're Delaware, you're okay with 2-point shots. Maybe a little quicker than you would have wanted, but 44 and a 10-second left. As long as Delaware protects the ball, they will win this game. But that's been easier than said than done so far tonight.
Yeah, the Hens struggling within the last 4 minutes with the Hofstra press. What we talked about, Erica Brown and Jody Salyer cannot play catch in the backcourt. You are not going to get the ball up the court. You don't want to go east and west. You want to go north-south right now. Hannah Jardine is back here in the front court. Get the ball up the court. Stephanie Leone is 6'4". Get the ball to the middle of the floor and have her turn and hit Hannah Jardine.
We saw it work earlier. We saw it work for a wide open three for Courtney Green. Been pretty impressive stuff from Delaware the way that they have been able to bounce back from adversity. It seems like every time they turn the ball over, every time Hofstra is poised to put together some type of a run, the Hens have found an answer. That's a great sign from a young team.
It is, from what we saw the last couple of CAA games where the Hens have taken shots and they haven't been able to bounce back. We saw at Towson, they went down 11. They tried to fight their way back, but that hole was too deep. Tonight, they're able to maintain that effort, maintain that hustle that at times was lacking in those first couple CAA games. And tonight they really did put together a full 40-minute game.
Inbound will come under their own basket. Sawyer running the baseline, and the ball tipped out of bounds by Hofstra. So now it will be a stationary inbound, or so you'd think. Only 0.4 of a second came off the clock. Inbound will come far sideline. Sawyer to trigger it. Still two timeouts left for Delaware. A half second just went off the clock before the ball went in. Now they get it into Brown, and Brown is fouled to the backcourt. Boy, the clock is doing some weird things tonight at the Carpenter Center. That one works out well for Delaware. They snuck a half second off the clock. Krista Kilburn-Stavesky calls the official over. It's like an extended debate when you watch Krista Kilburn-Stavesky coach a basketball game, isn't it? She has a lot to say to the official. She stays relatively calm. She loses her temper every once in a blue moon, but it is a constant dialogue.
It's very entertaining to watch both the Hofstra coach and Coach Martin at the same time.
First free throw good for Brown. She'll get one more. It's always entertaining to watch Tina Martin, the mic
and
up.
And coaching staff.
Yeah, the entire coaching staff. Second free throw good, lead up to nine. The Hens all-access feature they did last year with Tina Martin mic'd up was awesome. Jimmy Smith and his staff inside. Etta Faroka trying to go to work for Hofstra. Missed the layup. Rebound, Leon, and Delaware is going to win this game. Brown weaves her way through the entire Hofstra defense. Picks up the bounce, throws it over the top to Leon, hands it off to Sawyer. Near corner to Jardine, back out to Sawyer, who finally gets fouled. But at this point, it's all about padding Delaware's stats as the Hens are going to win a second consecutive game, and the streaky nature of this season will continue. The Delaware team that lost three of its first four, then won three straight, and then all of a sudden saw a streak where they lost six of seven. Now is one back-to-back games as Sawyer makes the first free throw. Never quite know what you're going to get with this team, but you know effort will be part of it as Sawyer knocks down a pair. And this team seems like they're learning how to win. Ed Efferoco will fire up another jumper. Why not? Can't hit. Brown, the weak side rebound. Boy, it's been a rough night for her. And Delaware will dribble out the clock. Bob Carpenter, center faithful, comes to its feet. And deservedly so as they let the Hens hear their appreciation for the effort. Delaware wins it tonight, 64-53. They improved to 7-9 on the season, 2-3 in league action, and they hand Hofstra their first league loss of the season as the Pride fall to 11-5, 4-1 in CAA action. We will take a break when we return the American Spirit post-game show. Once again, your final, Delaware 64, Hofstra 53.